Dear students, good morning, good evening, good afternoon. How are you? I hope best for you. I, Mukesh Kumar, welcomes you to online, Mukesh Online Academy. आपका मुकेश ऑनलाइन एकेडमी में स्वागत है. एंड वी आर डूइंग द मैथ्स ऑफ क्लास 8 फ्रॉम एनसीईआरटी बुक सीबीएसई बोर्ड. ओके, दैट इज द चैप्टर 2 लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन वन वेरिएबल. ओके, सो एज वी नो दैट द एनसीईआरटी बुक्स आर मेनली फॉलोड इनटू द सीबीएसई बोर्ड. नाउ दे हैव बीन स्टार्टेड इनटू द अदर बोर्ड्स आल्सो. Okay, so any board which have the linear equations chapter can benefit from these videos. Okay, so we have already covered this video into the this chapter into the previous 6 videos, in which we have covered the exercise 2.1, 2.2, 2.3 and some questions of the 2.4 along with the examples and introduction we have covered. I hope you would have seen those videos. If you have not still seen, then I have given the links into the description. It is better if you watch those videos, okay, first before watching this. That will give you more knowledge. Okay, that will make you understand this video in a better way. Okay, so now one tip. I hope you would have understood it. Have you taken out your notebook and pen? Take it out. You know, math is a subject of practice, so start practicing along with me. I am writing the question on the screen, you write it on the paper. Practice each and every question 3 to 4 times. You will become best into the maths, and I hope you must be doing that. You must be following that because you want to become best into the maths. Okay, so if you have any doubt, if you have any query, not only from this book, if you are following some other books related to it, then also you can send me the questions. So I will make another video for your queries. Okay, so you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. The description, I have given these details into the description. Okay, and I hope you must be getting knowledge from these videos. Kindly share with your friends, subscribe to it. Ask your friends to subscribe. And if you want to do the live online classes on the Zoom app, then also you can write to me. Then we will be happy to share the detail with you. Okay. So now in this video, we will do the remaining questions of exercise 2.4. Okay. Some questions we had done in the previous video. Now the remaining questions we will do in this. So let's start. So students, let's start. So today we will do the remaining questions of the exercise 2.4. Okay, so till question 4 we had done into the last video, and now in this video we will start from the question number 5. So now let's do the question number 5. So we have the question number 5 related to the age. Okay, the Shobo's mother present age is 6 times the Shobo's present age, and Shobo's age 5 years from now will be the 1/3 of his mother's present age. What are their present ages? Okay, so we have to find the age. Okay, so I'll just suggest you one thing. It is better to read the question 2-3 times so that we can come to know what is actually being asked. Okay, so here Shobo's mother present age is 6 times the Shobo's present age. So what we can do, we can just assume the Shobo's present age. Okay, so let Shobo's present age will be equal to x here. We have assumed it to be x here. Now first is given, Shobo's mother's present age is 6 times. So that means if the Shobo is 5 years, then the mother is 30 years. If the Shobo is 7 years, then mother is 6 into 7, 42 years. Okay, so if the Shobo's age is x years, then mother age will become 6 into x. This is the 6 x here. Okay, so we can write the mother's age equals to 6 x here because it is 6 times.
Okay. Now, so this first line we have solved that Shobo's mother present age is 6 times the Shobo's present age. So now, according to the next line, Shobo's age 5 years from now will be 1/3 of his mother's present age. So that means here, now we have to find the Shobo's age after 5 years. Okay. If the Shobo's present age is 5, then after 5, it will be 5 plus 5. If it is 10, then it will be 10 plus 5. If it is x, then it will be x plus 5. So we will write the age of Shobo after 5 years will be x plus 5 years. Okay. So now he will be 1/3 of his mother's present age. So that means Shobo will be equal to 1/3 of the mother's age. That means if the mother is 30, then he will be 1/3 of 30 is 10 years. So if it is 6x, so we have multiplied with the 1 upon 3. Okay. So we can divide 3 1 is 3, 3 2 is 6. So that means x plus 5 will become equal to 2x. Now we will take x to the other side. So it will become 5 equals to 2x minus x. That means 5 equal to x, or we can write x equals to 5. So what is the final answer that we have to write? That present age of Shobo will be 5 years, because we have got the value of x is 5 that we had assumed to be the present age. Now the present age of mother will be 6 into 5, because we have 6x, 6 times, so 6 into 5 is 30 years. Okay. So we have got the present age of Shobo 5 years and present age of mother as 30 years. So now let's explain it again. What we have done in this question, we have assumed present age of the Shobo as x. Okay. Clear? See, the mother age will become 6x because the mother is 6 times of the Shobo. Now, we have found the age of the Shobo after 5 years, that will become x plus 5. Okay. Because after 5 years means next 5 years. And it is written that 1/3 of the mother's present age. So that means the Shobo's 5 years from now is 1/3 of means 6x. Or you can write 1 upon 3 into 6x. So after solving it, we got the value of x is 5. So that means the present age of Shobo became 5 years and present age of mother became 30 years. I hope you would have understood this question. Okay. Now let's do the question number 6. So in the question number 6 we have, there is a narrow rectangular plot reserved for a school in Mahuli place. The length and breadth of the plot are in the ratio 11:4. At the rate of rupees 100 per meter, it will cost the village panchayat rupees 75,000 to fence the plot. What are the dimensions of the plot? Okay. So in question, there is a rectangular plot is given. Rectangular plot means the rectangle. This is the plot. Okay. Whose length and breadth are in the ratio 11:4. So the ratio of length and breadth is 11:4. Okay. So that means from this ratio, as we have done in other questions in the previous videos also, from this ratio, we can find the length and breadth of the rectangle. So the length of rectangle will become 11x meter. Okay. And the breadth of rectangle will become 4x meter. Okay. So what we have done in the ratio, we have just put a common value x. Okay. So that means it became 11x and it became 4x. Now what is given? That at the rate of rupees 100 per meter, it will cost the village panchayat rupees 75,000 to fence the plot. Okay. So the cost of fencing per meter is rupees 100, that is given. Okay. And total cost of fencing is rupees 75,000. Okay. So cost of fencing per meter is given rupees 100, and the cost of total cost means total cost of fencing rupees 75,000 is given. Fencing means they have to put the fence or the wire along the sides of the plot. That means they have to cover the entire perimeter. So that means we have to take the perimeter. So we know that it is actually, this question comes into the surface area and volumes, like the mensuration when we will study. But here you can understand to find the perimeter. This you have understood in class 6 and 7 also. Okay. So we have to find the perimeter. Okay. But perimeter is not given here. Total cost is given and cost per meter is given. That means if we multiply the perimeter by the cost per meter, then we get the total cost. Okay. So that means the total cost became equal to perimeter, or you can say the length of fencing. Okay. Perimeter means the total length of fencing into cost per meter. Okay. So perimeter total cost is given to be 75,000. Perimeter we need to find, and cost per meter is given 100 rupees. Okay. So by taking 100 to the other side, it will divide upon 100 equals to perimeter. Okay. So we can divide it. So perimeter of the rectangular plot became 750 meter. Okay. So now, as we know the formula perimeter of a rectangle, so the perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 bracket length plus breadth. So this is our L and this is our breadth. Okay. So we will put the values of length and breadth here. So perimeter we have already found, that is the 750. 2 bracket, the 11x is the rectangle length that we have got here. Okay. This is the length that we have got here, 11x. And 4x is the breadth that we have got here, plus 4x. So 750 will be equal to 2 into 11 plus 4 become 15x. Okay, and 2 into 15 became 30x. So now we will take 30 to the other side. So this will become x equals to became 750 upon 30. Okay, 0, 0 can be divided. Now 3 we can divide, 3 to the 6, 1, 3 5 to the 15. So we got x, value of x is 25. So now from this we can find the length and breadth. Okay, so what is was given in the length? So length equals to, we had the 11x. That means 11 into 25. That means 11, 5 to the 55, 11 to the 22, or 5 to 27. So 275 meter is the length. Breadth, we have already done there, 4x, that means 4 into 25, which means equals to 100 meter. Okay, so the length of the plot is 275 meter and the breadth of the plot is 100 meter. Now let's repeat. See, in this question, there is a rectangular plot whose dimensions, means length and breadth ratio, is given, that is the 11 into 2. Okay. Now, from this we have found the length to be 11x and the breadth to be 4x, and what is given? The cost per meter and the total cost of fencing is given. So by dividing these two, means 75,000 divided by 100, we got the perimeter, because the length of the fencing is always the perimeter. Okay. So now from this we got the perimeter, and then we applied the formula of the perimeter of a rectangle, which is 2 bracket L plus B. So whatever L and B we have got in 11x and 4x, we put into that. So by solving it, we got the value of x, and then we put the value of x into 11x and 4x. So we got the length as a 275 meter and the breadth as a 100 meter. I hope you would have understood this question. In case of any problem, you can write to me. We will again explain you this question. Okay. So now we will do the 7th question. See, in the 7th question, we have the Hassan buys 2 kinds of cloth materials for school uniforms. Shirt material that cost him rupees 50 per meter, and the trouser material that cost him rupees 90 per meter. For every 3 meters of the shirt, the material he buys 2 meter of the trouser material. He sells the materials at 20% and 10% profit respectively. His total sale is rupees 36,600. How much trouser material did he buy? I hope you know about the cost and sale price and profit formulas also. I'll tell you in this question. So we have to use those formulas here. Okay. So along with the linear equations. So we have the question. Hassan buys two kinds of cloth material for a school uniform. Shirt material that cost him rupees 50 per meter and the trouser material that cost him rupees 90 per meter. For every, so you can write, so whatever is given, first we can write that. So the cost per meter, number one shirt is rupees 50 and number two we have the pant material, that is the rupees 9. Okay. So the cost of 1 meter of shirt is rupees 50 and pant is rupees 90. So for every 3 meter of shirt, he buys 2 meter of the trouser material. So that means the ratio of shirt material to trouser material. See, for every 3 meter of shirt, he buys 2 meter of the trouser. So that means in the ratio 3:2, he buys the material. So we can write that the total shirt material. So let total shirt material he bought is 3x meter. We have taken x variable here. And the total pant material that he bought is the 2x meter. This is the total material that we have bought. Clear? Now, he sells the material at 12% and 10% profit. So first of all, we will have to find the cost price, whatever price he buys. So he buys at rupees 50 per meter and 90 per meter. So we can write that the cost price, or we can write this CP of shirt material. So since the per meter price is rupees 50 and he has bought 3x, so that means 3x into 50, which is rupees 150x is the cost price of shirt material. Okay. Now, the cost price CP of pant material will be equal to 2x into 90 because the pant is rupees 90 per meter. So, we got rupees 180x is the cost price of the pant material. So, he got the profit at 12%. Okay, so that means shirt profit is 12%. So we will find then the profit. So profit on shirt material. I hope you would have done the ratio and percentage into the class 7. So the profit on shirt material will be 12% of rupees 150. Because 150x is the total cost of the shirt material. So on this material, on this price, he will get the profit. Okay. So that means 12 upon 100. Whenever we convert the percent into the fraction, we divide by 100 into 150x. So we can divide 0 by 0. 5, 3 are 15. 5, 2 are 10. Then 2, 6 are 12. So we got 6 into 3x, which is equals to rupees 18x is the profit that he has. Okay, now we will find the profit on pant material. So profit on pant material. Profit on pant material will be 10%. Here it is given 10% profit. So 10% of what is the cost that we have got, 180x? This one. Okay, 180x. That means 10 upon 100 into 180x. So this zero gone, this zero gone. So we got the rupees 18x is also the profit on pant material. Okay. Now we will find the selling price. So selling price of shirt material. Total selling price. Okay. This we already know that selling price equal to CP plus profit. CP of shirt material. Okay. CP of shirt material is we have 150x and plus 18x. So we got the answer rupees 168 x is the total money that he has got from selling the shirt. Now the total SP of pent material we have to find, which will be equal to CP plus profit. So what is the CP? CP means CP we have the rupees 180x and profit we have got 18x. So we got the answer rupees 198x. See, if we have the profit, then to find the selling price we add it to the cost price. Had it been loss, then we would have subtracted it. Okay, since here it is profit, so we have added. So now we have find the SP of the shirt material and SP of the pant material. Now again see the question. Now after selling, his total sale is 36,600. So that means whatever selling price that we have got, we just have to add that. Okay, so 168x plus 198x, this is the total money that he has got, which is equal to 36,600. Okay, so we will just add 168 and 198. 8 plus 8, 16, 1, 9, 10 or 6, 16, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, we got 366. So 366x became equal to 36,600. Now we will take 366 to the other side. So the x became 36,600 divided by 366. So it will be dividing by 100. So we got the value of x is 100. Okay. So initially we had assumed the total material of the pant and total material of the shirt. So that means the total material for shirt was 3x. So that means 3 into 100, 300 meter. Okay. And the total material for pant will become 2x. That means 2 into 100, which is equals to 200 meter. So since they have asked you only the pant material, so we can write it is 200 meter. Okay. So I hope you would have understood this question. Now again, let's repeat the entire solution. What is given here? A person buys the material for shirts also and for the trousers also. You can say pant. I have written pant here, so trouser pant both are the same thing. Okay. So that means the cost per meter for shirt is rupees 50 and cost per meter for the trouser is 90 rupees. But he, for every 3 meter of the shirt, because the shirt takes the more cloth than the pant or trouser. So for every 3 meter of shirt, he has bought the 2 meter of the trouser material. So that means the ratio between the shirt material and the trouser material became the 3:2. Okay, so from this we have assumed that the total material that he has bought for the shirt is 3x and for the pant he has bought is the 2x. Then from, by multiplying them by the respective per meter cost, we can get the cost price of both the shirt and pant. And after getting the cost price of shirt and pant, we have got the profit 12% on the shirt and profit 10% of the pant material on the total cost price. Then we have found the sell price of the shirt and pant both by adding the cost price and profit. Okay. Then whatever money he is getting from selling the shirt and pant, that is total 36,600. So we got the equation 168x plus 190x equal to, and 198x equals to 36,600. So by solving it, we got the value of x. So we got the shirt material 300 meter and the pant material or the trouser material that you can get that 200 meter. Okay, so I hope you would have got this answer. Now we will do the next. So now the 8th question. In this question, half of the herd of deer are grazing in the field and 3/4 of the remaining are playing nearby. The rest 9 are drinking water from the pond. Find the number of the deer in the herd. Okay, so here there are some herd, means there is a collection of the deers. Okay, so half of the herd of the deer are grazing in field. We have to find the number of deer in the herd. So what will we do? Let total number of deer equals to x. We have assumed the total number to be X. Then what is given? Half of the herd of the deer are grazing in the field. So we will find the deer grazing in field. Number of deer grazing in field is half. That means X by 2. Then they have given 3/4 of the remaining. So we have to find the remaining. Remaining deer equal to X minus X upon 2. Because from the total number, if we subtract the X upon 2, then we will get the remaining. So we will do the same way that we have done in the rational numbers. So it will be 2X upon 2 minus X upon 2. Because the LCM will become 2. So it will be 2x minus x upon 2. So it will be x upon 2 is the remaining. Okay. So now 3/4 of the remaining. That means 3/4 of the x by 2 are playing nearby. So we will write number of deer playing. We have 3/4 of the remaining. So that means 3 by 4 into x upon 2. So 3 into x will be 3x that we have learned into the rational numbers, and 4 into 2 is 8. So 3x upon 8 are playing. The rest 9 are drinking water. So number of deer drinking water equals to 9. Find the number of deer. So that means this x upon 2, the number of deer grazing, this 3x upon 8. And this 9 will be equal to total number of deer x. So what equation that we have got? See, this is the number grazing in the field. Okay. And this is the number 3x upon 8 is playing plus 9 are drinking water, which is equal to the total number of deer that we have. Okay. So what we have done, what were the playing? We have counted all. So that is become to the equal to x. So what will we do? So we will write just 1 below the 9 and we will take the LCM of 2, 8 and 1. So LCM of 2, 8 and 1 will be 8 because 8 is the multiple of 2. So we will write 2, 4 the 8, so x into 4 by 2 into 4 plus 3x upon 8 plus 9 into 8 upon 1 into 8 is equal to x. So we got 4x upon 8 plus 3x upon 8 plus 9, 8 is 72 upon 8 will be equal to x. Okay. So this will become 8 became the LCM common. So 4x plus 3x plus 72 equals to x. So 4x plus 3 means 7x plus 72, and we can multiply this 8 with the x. So it will become 8x cross multiplication, we call it. Okay. So now we will take 7x to the other side. So 72 equal to 8x minus 7x. So that means we got the x equals to 7. So that means the total number of deer equals to 72. Now let's check it. The half of the 72 is 36. That means 72 minus 36 is remaining. Now 3/4 of it. 3.4 into 36. 4, 9 is 36. So 9 3 is 27. Okay. And 36 minus 27 is equal to 9, which are playing nearby. So if you add 36, 27 plus 9, then it became 70. I hope this is clear to you. What we have done in this question, we have assumed the number of deer to be x. Since the half are grazing in the field, so we just subtracted half of them from the total, so we got the x by 2, which is the remaining. 3 by 4th of it is playing, so we have multiplied x by 2 upon 3 with the 3 by 4, so we got the 3x upon 8. And the 9 are drinking water, so then we have just added all 3, that became equal to the total number of deer as a x. So after solving this equation, we got the total number of deer as a 70. Okay, so now let's do the ninth question. So in the ninth question, we have a grandfather is 10 times older than his granddaughter. He is also 54 years older than her. Find their present ages. So this is also related to the age. The grandfather is 10 times older than his granddaughter. He is also 54 years older than her. Find the present ages. So we can find the, we can just assume the age of the granddaughter. Okay. So let age of the present age. What we need to find? The present age of granddaughter. That assumed to be X. Now the grandfather is 10 times. That means the present age of grandfather is 10 times. That means 10x years. That means if it is 5, that means the grandfather will be 5 into 10. If it is 8, then grandfather will be 8 into 10. If it is X, then grandfather will be X into 10. That means 10x years. Now he is also 54 years older than her. So that means the grandfather is 54 years. Suppose if the age is 5, so that means 5 plus 54. If it is X, that means X plus 54. So that means X plus 54 is equals to 10X. Because the grandfather is 10X years and he is 54 years older than granddaughter. So if we add 54 to the X, then we will find the age of the grandfather. So we will just X take to the other side. So 10X minus X will be equal to 54. So 9X, 10X minus X is 9X equals to 54. So the X will become 54 divided by 9, because 9 go to the other side will divide it. So 9, 6 are 54. So we got the value X equals to 6. Okay. So the granddaughter age will be equals to 6 years. And the grandfather age will be equals to 6 into 10, which is equal to 60 years. So we can just subtract 60 and minus 6. So we got the 54. So that means our answer is correct. So we got the age of the granddaughter as 6 years and age of the grandfather as 60 years. I hope you would have got this question. Now we will do the last question, the 10th question of this exercise. Okay. So in the 10th question, Aman's age is 3 times his son's age. 10 years ago, he was 5 times his son's age. Find their present ages. You know, so many questions you are getting related to age. Okay. You just assume the present age of his son. Okay. So the present age of son, we are just assuming. So the lad present age of son is equal to X years. Okay. So Aman is 3 times his son's age. So the present age of Aman will become 3 times. That means 3x years, as we have understood in the previous questions also. Okay. So present age son we have assumed to be X, and the Aman's comes to 3x. Now 10 years ago he was 5. Now here 10 years ago. That means if the present age of the son is 15 years, so that means 10 years back he will be 5 years, means 15 minus 10. So we will subtract the 10 from the X and 3X both. Okay. So the age of son 10 years ago, it will be X minus 10 years. Same, we can find the age of Aman 10 years ago will be 3X minus 10 years ago, he was 5 times his son's age. That means that this Aman was 5 times of his son's age. Okay. So the age of the Aman was 5 times of the son. So that means 5 bracket X minus 10 equal to 3X minus 10. So we will just multiply 5 and X. And we will divide 5 and 10. So 5X minus 50 became equal to 3X minus 10. We will take 3X to the left hand side and 50 to the right hand side. So this will become 5x minus 3x, and this minus 50 will become plus 50 and minus 10. 5 minus 3 is 2, so that means 2x equals to 50 minus 10 is 40. And now we will take x to the other side, so it will divide it. So x 40 upon 2, so we got 20. So we got x equals to 20. And we have assumed the x to be the age of the son. So the present age of son will be equals to 20 years. Now Aman is 3 times, so that means present age of Aman will be equals to 3 into 20, which will be equal to 60 years. Now, check the answer and question both. 20 years is the present age, 60 years is the Aman's age. 10 years ago, 20 minus 10 will be 10 and 60 minus 10 will be 50. So, if we multiply 10 into 5, that means we got the 50. So, that means Aman was 5 times of his son's age 10 years ago. So, what we have done in this question, we have assumed the present age of the son. Okay. Then we just took the present age of Aman by multiplying it by 3. Then we took the present age of both Aman and son 10 years ago by subtracting 10 from their present ages. And since the Aman was 5 times of the present age of his son, so we just multiplied x minus 10 with the 5. Then we got the equation and multiplying and after solving it, we got the present age of the son 20 years and present age of the Aman 60. So this 2.4 exercise we have finished in this video. I hope you would have understood these questions. If you have any doubt, then you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. So, dear students, in the next video, we will do the examples and exercise 2.5. Examples related before the exercise 2.5 and exercise 2.5 we will do into the next video. Thank you so much for your watching. Write your comments about the video, any query, any doubt about the topic into the comment box. You can also write to me on the WhatsApp or email. The details I have given into the description. I hope you must be practicing the questions. You know, practicing the question 3 to 4 times is good to become best into the maths. Okay? So, if you want to do the live online classes through Zoom, the interactive, okay, and want to clear any doubt, then you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. We will be happy to share the detail with you. Okay? So, I hope you must be getting knowledge from these videos. Kindly share it with your friends. Subscribe to it. Ask your friends to subscribe. Thank you so much.